Hi, this is Sai Morton with the daily update on Eurofix. I post my exclusive market overviews with the key political and economical events, charts and important levels on the ForexBSami.com forums weekly. This short video is a response to rapidly changing situation on the currency markets and should help you to stand top of the game and be profitable. I suggest you to visit ForexBSami.com forum and read my analysis for the week before watching this daily video.
So let's talk again about the euro currency. This is the daily time frame, and yesterday we said that it's better to wait a bit since yesterday we haven't have any good opportunity for trading, and situation was really unclear. Well, by today's trading session we have some more clarity, but still there is significant lack of important patterns on the market. So one thing that we could see on the daily time frame is just now we have confirmed bear trend on the daily time frame. This black line is the MACD forecaster, and this is in fact the break-even point of the trend that is shown by MACD. So when the market closed below this line, trend turns to the bearish side by the MACD indicator. So now we have the bearish trend on the daily time frame as well on the weekly time frame. But now market still stands at support. So we can see that area has been tested three times since this retracement has started. You can see test first, test second. Now market again comes to this area. So from that standpoint, probably some pullbacks still could happen on the market. Well, you can see that trend will hold bearish on the daily time frame for today trading session till 125.60 area. It's right here. That is a significant moment for us. So let's take a look on the 4-hour time frame. On the 4-hour time frame, we see the trend has turned on the bullish side by the MACD indicator. Intraday trend is bullish. Well, here we have our pattern that we have discussed yesterday. So yesterday we said that such kind of price actions where often market shows some harmonic swings. You can see that this retracement is equal to that one. That one is a bit steeper, but the distance, the depth of this retracement is the same. Also, you can see that market almost has hit 1618 extension of that swing. And that low stands precisely at 1618 of that swing. So this probably could be treated as the three drive buy pattern. Also, this pattern has formed support. That is the 618 major support on the daily time frames right here. Also, that is the weekly pivot support one. It's 124.77. So that's some kind of support, and probably intraday traders could try to stick with this pattern to make the scalp trade against these lows. That is, will be the risk if market will continue to the upside and will take out that loss. That will be the failure point of this pattern. Just to remind you that the minimum target of this pattern is the high between the second and third bottoms. It's right here. So market probably should take out that high. Only after that we could tell that probably this pattern has worked properly. Still, since we have the 4-hour time frame trend on the bullish side, it suggests that market could show some deeper move to the upside. And we have two major areas to watch for. That is the first area of resistance, 125.30. That is confidence resistance on the 4-hour time frame. But I like this area. This is 125.60, 125.78 confidence resistance that include 3-8 resistance, major 3-8 resistance from the whole swing to the downside. Also, you could see that this is previous swing low on the 4-hour time frame. That was the support. Now this will be probably the resistance. Well, weekly pivot point stands a bit high, 126.10. So anyway, that is an area to watch for, is the potential area for sell patterns. Besides, daily trend will remain bearish right till that area. So from that perspective, this area is optimal to searching for the possibility to enter short. If even market will break this area to the upside, probably it will respect it for the first touch. That will allow you to protect your position by the moving your stop loss to break even or to tight it. So, and from that perspective, this area is nice. One thing that we would like to avoid to escape is the thrusting move to the upside with the huge candle, for instance, like here, but to the upside. In this case, if market will show this really strong move to the upside, do not enter short, since this explosive move to the upside could lead to some deeper move to the upside. Well, we need some gradual move to this area, not explosive kind. In this case, this area is very nice to search for the possibility to enter on the short side of the market. On the hourly time frame, we see this downward, you could call it parallel channel, that is combined with the MACD divergence. Hourly trend is also on the bullish side. Well, if we suggest that market intends to break it to the upside, in this case, what do we have? First area of confidence resistance on the 4-hour time frame is right here. It's 125.30 area roughly. So you can see also that is the classical support and resistance. That was the support, break to the downside, resistance, and again it will be the resistance. But applying the classical rule of the breakout, if we count the width of this channel and count it to the upside, we will get precisely an area of the second confluence resistance on the 4-hour time frame. It's around 125.60, 125.75. Also playing by this ugly ABCD pattern, I do not like it. In fact, this is maybe not even the pattern, but just extension. A, B, C, bottom. 100% extension stands around 125.40 area. So still it higher than confluence resistance on the 4-hour time frame. From that perspective, probably market still could reach the second area. That's why I mostly like the second confluence resistance as the potential area to search for the sell signals. Well, that is our current view on the market. Just as the conclusion, that's been said that although market has confirmed the bearish daily trend, intraday trends shows on upward direction, and market has formed some kind of a three-drive buy pattern on the 4-hour time frame. That suggests that probably market could show some pullback before and if any downward continuation will start in terms of the bearish weekly and daily trends. From that perspective, the major area to watch for sell signals is the confluence resistance on the 4-hour time frame around 125.60 area. One thing that we do not want to see is the explosive upward move on the 4-hour time frame, on the hourly time frame. If we will see any, then it's probably to wait and do not be hasty to enter blindly right from that area to watch some development. But if the this will be the gradual move to the upside, if even market will show some greater ABCD of the nice view on the hourly time frame, maybe on the 30-minute chart, well, and it will show the agreement with this area, well, that would be nice. We could try to enter short from this level. If even we will be wrong and market will break it to the upside, I suppose that on the first touch, market probably will respect this level, and this will allow us to protect the position if even we will become wrong with our expectation. Well, good luck to you. Do not be too hasty and wait for the confirmation from the market. Watch for reaching of level that we have just discussed.